plant tissues. We all know that plants are also living beings like us. They respire, prepare food, and have unlimited growth throughout life. So, how do they perform all these functions? Plants are composed of three major organ groups: roots, stems, and leaves. These organs are made up of various tissues that perform these functions. Large number of specialized cells together form a tissue. Plant tissues are characterized and classified according to their structure and function. The two basic types are the meristematic and permanent tissues. Let us first look at the meristematic tissue. It is the meristematic tissues that help in the growth of a plant, as they have the ability to divide themselves. Their cells are similar, generally small, enclosed within thin walls and a cubicle. Depending on the region they are present in, meristematic tissues are classified as apical, lateral, and intercalary. The tissue that helps increase the length of the stem and the root is the apical meristem. It is located at the tips of stems and roots. Which tissue then helps in increasing the diameter of the plant body? It is a lateral meristem, located at the lateral position of the stem or the root. How then do the leaves and the branches grow? It is the intercalary meristem that facilitates the growth of leaves and branches. In grass, these generate the parts removed by the grazing herbivores. It is located at the base of the nodes, internodes, and on leaf bases. We now know how a plant develops its roots, stem, leaves, and branches. Now, let's find out which type of tissues help plants to obtain necessary nutrition and support. It is the permanent tissues that help in transport, preparation of food, and provide support for the plants. Permanent tissues are none other than meristematic tissues that mature and become differentiated to form different types of tissues. Based on the similarity of the cells, permanent tissues are classified into simple, permanent, and complex permanent tissues. Simple permanent tissue is called simple tissue because it is composed of similar types of cells that have a common origin and function. Based on the function, they are further classified into parenchyma, collenchyma, and sclerenchyma. The parenchyma tissues are oval-shaped cells with thin cell walls and have extensive spaces between the cells. They aid in photosynthesis, storage, and also help aquatic plants to float. They are composed of living cells found in roots, stems, leaves, and flowers. The collenchyma tissues are composed of living, elongated cells. They provide elasticity, mechanical support, and tensile strength to the plant body. They are found mainly in the cortex of stems and leaves. The sclerenchyma tissues are dead cells having extremely thick cell walls containing lignin. They protect the plants. This tissue is present in stems, leaves, and in the hard covering of seeds and nuts. We'll now move on to the second type of permanent tissue, the complex permanent tissues. As the name indicates, complex permanent tissues consist of more than one type of cell. They are classified into xylem and phloem. Xylem is a complex tissue consisting of tracheids, vessels, xylem parenchyma, and xylem fibers. It transports water and minerals as raw materials from the roots to the other plant parts. Phloem consists of sieve tubes, companion cells, phloem fiber, and phloem parenchyma, which transports prepared food from leaves to the other parts of the plant. In conclusion, we have seen and understood the plant tissues, their types, subclassifications, and their functions. Things to remember: plant tissues are basically classified into meristematic and permanent tissues. meristematic tissues divide throughout their life and promote plant growth. Permanent tissues are divided from meristematic tissues and facilitate transport, preparation of food, and provide support to plants.